now you can see my needle threader in action. You first thread that through the eye of the needle.
And it's a wonderful honor to have this opportunity to share with you the science that we've done over the last few years and to discuss the extraordinary opportunities and exciting advances that are happening right now with CRISPR-Cas9 as a genome editing technology. I thought I would begin by telling you about the origin of the ideas around CRISPR. This began at least two decades ago with research in microbiology laboratories showing that bacteria might have an adaptive immune system, a way to provide protection against viral infection that would allow cells to acquire it in real time and then protect the cells from those viruses using this recording system in the genome. And this system came to be called CRISPR. And as I'm showing here, this is a mechanism by which bacteria and archaeal cells can adapt to viruses by integrating small pieces of viral DNA into the organism genome at a site called CRISPR, and then using that information to make an RNA copy of the sequence that can then provide the information required for detection and cleavage of viral DNA or sometimes viral RNA using CRISPR-associated or Cas proteins. And this slide shows the way this system is thought to act in bacteria and represents experiments that were done in the field early on, both using bioinformatics and molecular genetics to understand the function of this pathway. I do a triple knot. This video shows the way that we imagine CRISPR operates in nature, where bacteria that might be growing in a biofilm are being infected by viruses. And when the virus injects its DNA into the cell can acquire a small piece of that foreign DNA into the CRISPR locus, a place in the genome that consists of repeated sequences that flank these integrated sequences from viruses that are called spacers. And the cell then makes a copy of that integrated sequence in the form of RNA, which is then processed into individual units that include a sequence derived from a virus. Those RNAs combine with a second type of RNA called tracer and a protein called Cas9 to form a surveillance complex, an RNA-guided protein that can search the cell looking for sequences that match the sequence of the guide RNA. And when a match occurs, the CRISPR-Cas protein, Cas9, is able to cut double-stranded DNA, triggering destruction of the DNA in a bacterial cell. And this pathway has been operating for a long time, over evolutionary time, evolving in bacteria, and has over time been diversified into many different forms of CRISPR systems that can operate effectively in these organisms. But today, I'm actually going to talk about, in particular, about one type of CRISPR-Cas system that uses the protein Cas9, as I showed in that example. This slide shows the three steps in CRISPR-acquired immunity that include adaptation, expression, and interference. And in the research that I did in my laboratory with a number of my former students, beginning with Blake Wiedenheft and then Rachel Horowitz, and folks that came after them, we began investigating, in particular, this third step in the pathway called interference, the stage of the CRISPR pathway that involves an RNA-guided detection of viral DNA. Back in 2011, we had the good fortune to begin a collaboration with Emmanuelle Charpentier and her student Christoph Chylinski. And this launched a wonderful opportunity to answer what was at the time a very interesting and intriguing question in the CRISPR field, namely, what is the function of the protein called CRISPR-Cas9? And we were fascinated by this question because this particular protein had been implicated in protection of cells, and in particular, a type of bacteria that Emmanuelle's group was studying called Streptococcus pyogenes, an organism that infects human beings. And this particular organism has a CRISPR-Cas9 protein encoded in its CRISPR system that was implicated in protection of cells from viral infection. But the question was how? And so in our collaboration, we investigated this and addressed the question by doing biochemical experiments that involved working with purified CRISPR-Cas9 protein and the RNA that guides it to target DNA sequences in cells. And what we found, and this is research done by Martin Yinek, a former postdoc in my laboratory, and Chris Chylinski working in Emmanuel's laboratory, is that CRISPR-Cas9 in nature is a dual RNA-guided protein. As I showed in that introductory video, this is a protein that uses a CRISPR RNA molecule to direct it to a sequence of DNA that matches the CRISPR RNA sequence. And it also requires a second RNA molecule called tracer that provides an interaction with the CRISPR RNA required for assembly with Cas9. And so together, these two RNAs guide Cas9 to DNA sequences where the protein Cas9 is able to make a cut in the double helix of DNA. I think one of the wonderful aspects of CRISPR and this project with Emmanuel's group is that this was the point in our research where what began as a curiosity-driven investigation morphed into a project that had much broader implications. Because once we understood how nature uses a dual RNA system to guide Cas9 to target DNA sequences, it was possible to engineer the dual RNA guide as a single guide RNA shown here that included both the targeting information and the structural requirement for assembly with the Cas9 protein in a single RNA molecule. And once this experiment was done by Martin and by Christoph, we found that Cas9 could be programmed with single guide RNAs and directed to cleave double-stranded DNA at a desired sequence, taking advantage both of the actual targeting information in the CRISPR RNA molecule, as well as the requirement for what's called a PAM sequence, a protospacer adjacent motif. PAM is easier. That occurs right next to the target sequence in the DNA. And those two elements are required for Cas9 to recognize and cleave DNA. But this requirement is sufficient for Cas9 to function as an RNA-guided DNA cleaver. And I wanted to show you a key experiment that Martin Yinek did to test this idea of a single-guided Cas9 protein that could cleave different sequences of DNA. And the experiment was to design guide RNAs that would recognize several different sequences in a plasmid DNA, a circular piece of double-stranded DNA that we could purify in the laboratory.